if we were going through stuff right now, I'll be like,
All right, it looks sad already. Let's get into it. Only time you ever call me is when you feel alike. Don't nobody else wanna listen. When's the last time you saw me? You probably don't remember that, cause that was back when you were different. I don't wanna hear the stories. I'm tired of all the talking, to be honest. I would rather see a different chain pass me in the hallway. But you ain't said a word to me lately. All I ever feel is this, and you don't care that you lost me. What's wrong with you? Had a picture of you sitting on the dash in the car with me. Now it's in my closet with the other one sitting in the box. I don't wanna open up. You took it off. Okay. So he's going through some girl drama.
Yeah, I wonder if this is based on a real incident.
Probably, because he just writes about his life. We should have listened to the previous song before we listened to this one. I'm trying to tie it all together. Well, the last one was Therapy Session, right?
Right.
And then Therapy Session. Okay, that was like about his fans and stuff, and he was in therapy. Okay. So maybe this ties together with a different one or something. But that's what I'm getting right now. Girl drama. And based on the first picture, it seemed like a car accident. He was holding her or something. Right. So maybe she like passed away when they were on bad terms or something. I don't know. We'll see. Took it all from me. Told me you would die for me. Yeah. All you ever do is lie to me. Wish that I could say that this is coming as a surprise to me. Tell me that I never took the time and now you ain't got the time for me. Yeah.
I remember that. I guess I don't know what happened to us. Now you got me questioning what trust is. You told me you would be there for me, yeah, but you ain't really mean it, did you? Now you wanna jump ship. Leave me here alone while I'm used to it. Everybody else did. Who you having fun with? Don't tell me I don't wanna know. Every time I ask, I just feel sick. You don't wanna jump in. Told me you had feelings. Now you trying to tell me that it's not true. I ain't got a clue who I'm looking at right now, but I know the person that I'm looking at is not you. Yeah, they say you are who you hang with. Maybe that's the reason why I'm feeling like you're dangerous. And every time we talk, it's like I'm talking to a stranger.
Okay, what overall message are you getting from this so far? I mean, I'm sure it'll tie it together at the end. But so far, what are you getting?
Sounds like it's about his relationship. Like a rocky patch in that relationship.
Right.
I mean, I feel it. Like, when it's rough, it's rough.
Right.
And so, like,
so like these are the thoughts he was thinking during the relationship. But it's not that it was all like her fault necessarily, right?
No, I'm not getting that vibe. I'm just getting that like she's hanging with different people and they're not vibing, they're not on the same page, like.
Right. See, I'm getting the vibe that like she switched up.
Yeah.
But that's what it seems like sometimes when you're in a relationship, like the other person's fault, they switched up. So I feel like he's just like chronicling like what he's going through in the relationship, like
right.
His thoughts at the time.
I just wonder how this accident ties into that.
Right.
Because right now it seems like they're not messing with each other. Like she didn't talk to him in the hallway. Like,
you know what I mean? Right, but like, it's like she switched up because she's maybe hanging around different people. Like she got brand new. You know what I mean? Yeah. But I feel like it always feels like that with drama and relationship drama. It always feels like the other person's fault.
Yeah.
So I wonder if it's something like that. I mean, sometimes it is the other person. It can't be both people's.
Right.
Complete fault, like someone usually is more.
And it always feels like the other person.
It always feels like
the other person's acting different, like yeah.
Right, right.
That's true.
Okay, I never remember everyone did or that.
Told me you had feelings, now you're trying to tell me that it's not true. I ain't got a clue who I'm looking at right now, but I know the person that I'm looking at is not you. Yeah, they say you are who you hang with. Maybe that's the reason you've been changing. Maybe that's the reason why I'm feeling like you're dangerous. And every time we talk, it's like I'm talking to a stranger. When did you get so cold?
I think that whole accident and everything was, like, symbolic. She's dead to him. Like, they spiraled out of control.
Right? That's what I was beginning to think, too. But I don't get it.
What do you mean?
Maybe it was, like you were saying, like, toxic or something? I don't get how the accident ties in. I was thinking it was brand new. Like, or like it was symbolic because she got brand new, but then why were they together? And he was driving the car, right? And he crashed the car, and then she might be dead.
Yeah.
But I mean, because she's not necessarily dead because they didn't put her in a body bag.
True.
So it's like she might have died, or maybe she didn't.
Right. Yeah, I feel like they lost control. And she might end up dead to him.
Yeah, definitely seemed to be going that path. But I was just interested in the relationship itself. Because mm-hmm. it seemed like it was just his perspective on what was going on in their relationship. But were they in a relationship if she's like acting like she doesn't see him in the hallways and stuff like that? Or did they just...
They probably broke up. And right. It was after the breakup.
Right, right.
But I mean, that is true, like... You know, when you're dating somebody for a while, it's like, when you break up, that, like, one-on-one time and, like, that relationship you have with them, it's like, you don't feel like that doesn't exist anymore just because you broke up. But then when you see them, it's very strange because it's like, they might be dating other people, you know what I mean? You're not supposed to act a certain way, but it's like, sometimes you just want to freaking give them a hug.
Right, but, that face you just made... But what about when one person may feel like that and the other doesn't? Because what if one person is already with the new person and happy with that? Yeah, and the other sucks. Person is still like, oh, I thought we were going to get back together. Sucks. You know what I mean? I could see, like, maybe she was like that, and so she doesn't want to see him, and he wanted to give her a hug.
Yeah. But also, I just feel like in situations like that, like, when you don't, like, cool down... for a decent amount of time, re-get to know yourself, that next relationship, no matter how happy and all this stuff, it's like, that is, like, the version of you that's, like, trying to move on. That's not just, like, the, like, baseline settled, you know what I mean?
Like, not your truest self.
Right. Like, I feel like a lot of times that, like, rebound person, that relationship, even though it's so happy and everything, doesn't always end up being, like, what... you really want. It's just like a nice distraction.
Right, it's like a filler person.
Yeah. But it sucks to be in his shoes in that situation because he's not like moving on. You know what I mean?
Right. Yeah, I mean, based on the title, I just want to know. It sounds like, yeah, he hasn't moved on. Like, he has questions unanswered.
Yeah. It's crazy. Like, seriously, relationship problems are like some of the worst pain ever.
Right? I saw... It was a YouTuber I used to watch. His daughter had committed suicide because of a like relationship problem in high school. Like, her boyfriend dumped her or whatever. And he made a video about it, like, within, like, 2 days or something. So it was still, like, raw to him. Mm. You know what I mean? Like, he was explaining the situation. Like, it was crazy. But, yeah, I feel like relationships, definitely, especially when you're young, even older... Even older people, it doesn't even matter the age, really. That is some of the biggest drama.
It is. Because it's like, sometimes you just don't be on the same page. But it's like, it's crazy when like, that vulnerability and that like, opening up to another person and like, kind of like, merging parts of your life together, you know what I mean? And then it's like, when that's shaky or when it's not there, it's like, that sucks.
Right.
And then like, just for her to move on so easily, it's like, how insulting. You know what I mean? And I doubt she actually has, like, replaced him and moved on. But, like, how she presents herself is, like, she's doing fine. You know what I mean? He's like, you got brand new. Because it's like, nobody's doing fine after a breakup. Unless they were mentally broken up long ago.
Right, but that happens.
It does. Like, people will stick around even though they're done. And the other person's still, like, up to date on the relationship. And then... they're out the door, and it's like, dang, you got remarried in like 2 months.
Right. Like some people end the relationship in their head. Mm-hmm. And so they're on the market, but still in the relationship because they haven't ended it in the real world yet. You know what I mean? So like that, yeah. That happens.
Personally, I think that is cowardly. just because I feel like it's real convenient to, like, not go through the hardship of the breakup and to, like, you know what I mean? That person isn't going anywhere. So it's, like, basically, I feel like it's just a little bit, like, you know, it's not straightforward. You know what I'm saying? That's not street code. It's just not, like, to me, it just goes against the code of, like, how you would like to be treated in the world. You know what I mean?
Right, but that's the thing about the code is not everyone follows it, so is there even a code?
Right, and then it's like, you know, the people who follow the code, it's like, okay, we can all, you know, link up and stuff, but then it's like you deal with one person who doesn't, and now it's like, is it even worth following the code?
Right, now you're scarred for life.
Yeah. Because it's like, yeah.
It's like a decent code would just be like, treat others how you would like to be treated.
Yeah.
But everyone doesn't live by that.
We all should.
But a lot of us don't.
A lot of people don't.
And then we all fall short sometimes. Yeah. You know what I mean?
For sure.
So it's like.
For sure.
What is the code?
I just feel like she just like, I feel like she kind of like dogged him out in this situation.
It sounds like it. But with relationships, I always want to hear both sides of the story.
Yeah, that's true.
Always.
That's true.
Because like, yeah, we all do stuff. But sometimes one party in the relationship could be way more at fault. Mm-hmm. You know, like we both will contribute, but one party could be the party to blame for something. Right. But I like to hear both sides of relationship stories.
That's so true. I actually saw today online, I was like on Reddit or something, and this dude cheated on his girlfriend, right? And then she was like, well, if you want me to stay with you, you have to get my face tatted on you 20 times. And so he got her face tatted. Literally, like this, like the side of her face.
Oh, he posted pictures?
He posted pictures. I gotta find it. Anyway, 20 times, and she wouldn't get back with him. I was like, that's savage.
Oh,
my goodness.
That
was just her payback.
Right?
Savage.
Tripping.
But yep, so the next song is the... The one
much
awaited. Been talking about. Yeah. I wonder if it's a rap or a song or like a mix.
Guess we'll find out soon enough.
We'll find out. Yeah. I think it's important he writes about stuff like this. Because, man, it's like when you're not going through this, it's like, oh, we can watch the song and be like, oh, you know, I think he's going through something since the relationship.
Right.
But if we were going through stuff right now, I would be like, I feel like that. You know what I mean? I'd be like, he moved off. I'd be so into it.
All right, thanks for joining us on the journey. I am confused about what is on the journey and what isn't, so I don't know. We're just going to use the list we have. It's pretty long, and we're just going to do the list because everyone has a different list.
I'm thoroughly confused. All so different.
I am so confused.
Yeah.
So confused. But thanks for joining us on the journey. We appreciate you. All the likes, all the comments, all the love in the comments and stuff. It's like no other journey we've been on. Appreciate it.
I still want to understand this one.
Right. Let us know your interpretation of this one in the comments.
Yeah, for sure.
That's a wrap.
I don't know. Tell me, man, what do you know? What do you know? Me and my boys on the road. You the go. She told me, boy, you the go. Like, I don't know. But I don't know.